Hello, I'm going to take a few moments to give you an overview of Google account security. And this is something that's been done in other videos by others. But I want to show you a little bit more about how to make sure you keep your password safe. So the first thing is a website called haveibeenpwned.com. Now, this is have I been PWNED.com. And this is going to check and see if your account has been compromised or has if it's been leaked in one of the recent data leaks, which they happen often. But you'll want to put your email address in this to see if you've been if your data has been exposed through some data leak. So that's the first step in checking your security. So my email address is I'm not really worried about it being seen. It's pretty public. It's kind of all over the internet. So anyway, what I could find is, oh no, pwned. And so I can see that I've been it's been collected in breached 8 breach sites and 3 pastebins. And so this tells me a little bit about the companies that were careless with my data. And but what do you do from here, right? So you could go and say, oh, I want to go change my passwords and remove everything. But so passwords are, you want to change those, but you don't necessarily have to go change your email address all the time. But so one thing you want to do is use this particular site and actually check your password. So I'm going to put in a password here that I know has not been exposed. And so you can see what it looks like. And it says good news. You haven't been pwned with that password. Now, pwned, it just means that you have been exposed online. And so what will happen if you put in a password that you use often possibly or with other sites and you want to check it? Oh no. Now it also gives you an indicator that the password's been seen multiple times. If the password has previously appeared in a data breach, it should never be used. So what I want to do is I want to go and actually check my Google account security, and I want to see, first of all, I really want to look for sites that have this particular password. And I'm gonna have a little bit of a hard time actually finding that if I don't remember what they are. But I want to show you about Google account security. So when I'm at my Google account, and I can do that by clicking on my little icon and choose Manage your Google account. That's in when I'm logged in. Now, because I'm using Google Chrome with my web browser, it has a built-in password store, and it syncs if you're logged in your browser, and you know you're logged in your browser if your avatar appears right here in the top of the screen. Then that is how you know that the things that you save in your browser are being synced to Google. So I'm going to go down to security, and it tells me that there are security issues found. I just want to ignore all this other stuff there and go down specifically and look at the password manager. So when I look at the password manager, this is going to be all the passwords that I have my browser save. And the reason why I do that is because I try to have passwords that are unique, and I try to utilize the ability of the browser to randomly assign passwords when I log in or create accounts on websites. But I'm going to use this check passwords facility and actually have Google run through my password list, and it's going to force me to authenticate. So I'm going to do that. Now you want to make sure your Google password is very strong, and that doesn't necessarily mean that you have to have a whole bunch of weird random characters. It just means it needs to be pretty long. Okay, so once I authenticate on Google, I'm going to be looking at my password screen, and notice it says here that I reuse some passwords, and then some passwords here are using weak passwords. So that's where I'm going to focus right here. I also noticed that it says that no passwords have been compromised. Now, that generally means that there was a point where one of my passwords was compromised here, and it indicated that was the case, and so I went and changed it. But what I will have here when I start looking at all of the accounts is I will have my actual login here, and I can go in and actually change a password. Now these are sites that I have asked Google to save, and so I can also go through and delete them if I decide that there's one that I don't want. What I will do is I will go in and actually just choose that and tell it to delete, and it'll actually ask me to confirm it. That way it's not saving all my passwords. So what I'll do is I'm going to go and change my JetPens password. So I'm going to click on the link, and it's going to get me to the page of the account. Now I'm going to click log in here. Now this is going to be different for every site. Now notice that when I click log in, that my username and password were filled in. The reason why they're filled in is because my web browser, which I'm logged into, knows that this is my password and my email address for this site, and it has synced it from my Google Passwords account. So I'm going to go ahead and log in. This is the data that's stored correctly right now in my browser. Now, remember, I want to change my password, and so I'm going to go and walk through the process of changing my password. And every site is different on this, okay? But you just have to do it. So, what's my current password? When I click that field, it automatically tells me, oh, it's this password we have stored. So when I click new password, what I want to do is I want to choose suggest strong password, and I'm going to put that in here. Yeah, I understand that that's probably, I'm going to blur that out so that you don't see the password, but notice it filled it in. And I'll click save changes. Now, what's happened is that password's been updated on this particular website, JetPens. Now, I'm getting a notification from Google Chrome that the browser that it wants to know, do you want to update your password? Now, this is coming from the web browser because it has a window here, it has the key that's open. And I'm going to go ahead and choose update password, but it says passwords are saved in your Google account, so you can use them at on any device. Now, what happens is when I click update password, that information is going to go first in my browser's cache, then it is going to sync to Google, and it will be able to be accessible on any other device that I have a Chrome browser installed that is synced to Google, or it will be found on passwords.google.com. So, I've done that process. Sometimes when you go and change a password, now I can just close the window out. But sometimes when you go and change the password, it will actually not record the username right, and you'll have to go in and modify this. So, let's just say that I wanted to go in and modify a password. I would need to click this is called a hamburger menu right here. They have these vertical ellipses, and I want to update that password, and it's going to actually give me a box to fill in my username and change my password for this particular site, and then I can save it. So again, this is in the Google Passwords account on the Google site. Notice that this particular page is secure. It has a encrypted link between the page and the server. It is once I update the password on Google site, it's gonna backward sync to my Chrome browser. Right, so that the browser that I'm logged into keeps these things synced up. If I don't see my picture here, I'm not logged into this browser with the Google syncing. It's not gonna be syncing. So, what I want to do is go through here and find, and I can, when I click change password, remember I'm going to be clicking an external link to go to that website. If I just want to see what the password is, I can click view password, and it tells me what the password is right there in that window. So I can see it, and I can decide, is that one of the passwords that I want to change, or do I want to leave it the same right now? So that's a way to help me. I can click view password. Now, this particular one, I do want to change it. So I'm going to go through that process. I'll show you how that works. Now, this is live.com. It's going to be a Microsoft site. It's going to be on the complicated side of things. We're going to go ahead and do it. Now, notice there are three or four accounts on live.com. So this is just going to be a kind of a complicated process. Now I'm going to go ahead and I am going to remove one of these. Going to click on my link. Now taking me to live.com. Notice I have a, when I click in the field, I get a drop down and ask me which one do you want to do. So I'm going to pick that and click next. It's going to autofill my password. This is the password that's synced from Google, saved in the browser. I'm going to click sign in. Now sometimes you gotta hunt for these options, but in this case, this is a Microsoft account. I want to go in and actually change the password, so I'm going to change it. And this is going to take me into Microsoft's identity verification utility, where I'm going to have to go through a process to do that. So if I had other authentication methods, I would be able to see it. But in this case, I'm going to choose my email. It's going to give me a code, which I'm going to go and actually use my chosen device. In this case, I'm going to use my phone. And it just sent me a code to my email address, which I'm going to grab real quick. And I'm going to put that code in. It's a one-time PIN. It's I'm not worried about anybody seeing it. Okay, now notice I don't know my password, so I got to be sure when I have it autofill that I use the right account. So, and remember that it was third in the list on the first screen, but it's the first one now. It's the Gmail address. Now I'm going to click in the new password field, and I'm going to be sure I choose suggest strong password, and I'm going to use that. Now, one thing you notice about that is this particular case, this particular password, notice it has special characters. Sometimes you'll see commas, you'll see periods and things like that. Those are good. You can put those in. I'm going to go back in and change this so you're not gaining any information there after seeing this password. But that password's been changed. I immediately get a notification. Does it say, do you want to update it? Yes, I do. And then I can close that window out. So that's the process of updating the password. And you just basically you just go through this whole process and do it on your accounts. So that gives you some just some guidelines of how that process works. You want to be sure always that you understand that your passwords are stored in Google's cloud. They're synced to your local browser, which is the program you're using to browse the web. Then they're also synced to any other device that you have Google Chrome or Android password managed in the device. So if you have a Google Chrome browser on a device and you've logged into it with your Google account, you're going to sync your passwords. The Apple keychain on iPhones work the same way. If you have Google Chrome and you download it on your iPhone, you'll be able to utilize this password manager here. This is not the only password manager. You can have others such as LastPass or KeepPass, but they work basically the same way. So thank you very much for the video. Hope you enjoyed it.